Hi guys, in this video we are going to discuss Morgan's experiment on linkage and crossing over. So let's start with it. First, what is linkage? Linkage is basically when two genes, now let us consider two genes as capital A, capital B. Now these two genes are located close to each other, okay? So there are chances that this both will, what, they will be inherited together in next generation. Now imagine if these genes are passed on from parent to offspring. So offspring will be of what? Parental type. Okay, so you will obtain what? When the genes lie close to each other, you will obtain more percentage of what? Parental type. Is this clear? Now the second case. Okay, when genes are located far away from each other. Let us consider capital A and capital B only, the same genes, but now they are placed distant. Now they are located widely. Located what? Widely. That is far away from each other. Now what happens? There are chances of crossing over. Now when crossing over occurs, what happens is the position of the genes again changes, and now there is no chance of what? Inheriting together. So they are not inherited together. Is it clear? Now when the position is changed, there are chances of what? Obtaining new combinations. Okay, so because of crossing over, what happens is percentage of new varieties, or you can say recombinant type, increases. Okay, so there are chances of obtaining what? Recombinant types. Is it clear? Yes. So when they are close to each other, you obtain more parental type, and when they are far away, you obtain what? The chances of obtaining recombinant type increases. Okay, so now let's start with the cross. Okay, so now what Mendel did? Mendel carried out dihybrid cross, Mendel had carried out dihybrid cross. So now Morgan, he also carried out what? Dihybrid cross. So Morgan carried out dihybrid cross. Okay, now in this case, in dihybrid cross, what he did is he carried out experiment using Drosophila. Now Drosophila is what? Nothing but the fruit fly. Now in this case, what he did is, let's start with the cross. Okay, considering male, okay, male have X chromosome and Y chromosome, okay, and female consists of 2X chromosome. Okay, so in case of X and Y, in male you have Y plus and W plus. So you use small alphabet, but plus sign denotes what? Your wild type, that is the dominant type. And here you have Y and W. Okay, so this is what? Another variety. Now in this case, what is the phenotype of male? Phenotype of male is brown. They have brown body. So they are brown bodied and red eyed. Okay, and in this case you have yellow. Y stands for what? Yellow body. That is, the male is yellow bodied and white eyed. The female is yellow bodied and white eyed. Now when you carry out a cross in between them, you get gametes. So here in textbook they have not shown gametes. We will be showing gametes here. So now this will go into, because of meiosis, when meiosis occurs, these chromosomes will separate. Okay, and now some of the male gametes have this chromosome, that is X chromosome, Y plus, W plus. Okay, and some of the male gametes have what? Y chromosome. Okay, now in this case you have, in female you have only one type of gametes. Okay, because on both the chromosomes there is Y and W. So there is formation of only one type of gamete, that is the egg will contain X chromosome having Y and W. Okay, so when this male gamete fuses with this female gamete, you get an organism in F1 generation, okay, having y plus w plus, okay, and you have here you have y and w, okay. Then again when this gamete fuses with female gamete, you get an individual having y and w and y chromosome. Okay, so these are the progenies. This is female and this is male. Now when these are intercrossed, you intercross F1 progenies, and what happens here is you obtain gametes. First you will have gametes. Okay, so female, let's see the gametes of female. The first gamete is Y plus, is the chromosome having Y plus W plus, right? And another gamete consists, so this is one gamete, this is another gamete which consists of Y and W, okay, that is this only. Now the more two gametes are formed, which are formed due to what? Due to crossing over. So now you get another gamete having, now here you have Y plus W plus, now you will have a gamete having Y plus W, okay, because here the position changes, there might be chance of what? Crossing over. So here you have, this gamete will have Y plus W, okay, and another, the last gamete will have what? Last gamete, see here you have Y plus W in this gamete, Y plus W. So here in the next gamete you have what? In the last type of gamete you have YW plus, okay. So these are new combination, okay, and these are parental combination of gametes. Now here you have only two types of gametes, that is one with YW, okay, this gamete is with YW, and another gamete is with Y chromosome, okay. So X chromosome having YW and Y chromosome, here X chromosome is present in this gamete having Y plus W plus, here Y and W, here Y plus W, and here YW plus. So these are two parental and these are new combination of gametes. So four female gametes and two male gametes. I hope this is clear. Now let us see what do you get in F2 generation. Now F2 generation is shown in what? In Punnett square. So let's see Punnett square here. In Punnett square, you will show male gametes, okay? You will show male gametes here, okay, that is, let us see the male gamete Y and W, okay, this is one male gamete. Another male gamete consists of Y chromosome, okay. Then let us see the female gametes, okay. Now here you have female gametes having Y plus W plus, okay. So there are four types of female, Y plus, the X chromosome having Y plus W plus, okay, this is present in one gamete. In another gamete again there is parental combination Y and W, okay, on X chromosome. Then third female gamete consists of X chromosome having new combination, that is Y plus W, and the last gamete, female gamete, consists of X chromosome with what? X chromosome with YW plus. Okay, so now let's see when this male gamete fuses with this female gamete, what do you get? You get two X chromosomes, right? Okay, two X chromosomes with one with Y plus W plus and another with Y and W. Now here, when this male gamete fuses with this female gamete, you have again one X chromosome with Y plus W plus and another is Y chromosome. Now here again we see when this male gamete fuses with this female gamete, you have again two X chromosomes, okay, one with Y and W, another X chromosome with Y and W. Now here when this male gamete fuses with this female gamete, you have what? X chromosome with and Y chromosome, yes, X chromosome with Y and W, and Y chromosome is devoid of this genes. Now next, see here, when this male gamete fuses with this female gamete, you have two X chromosomes, yes, two X chromosomes with one with Y plus W, yes, and another with Y and W. Okay, then next, here when this male gamete fuses with this female gamete, you have Y plus W, okay, and the Y chromosome. Okay, then next after that is when this male gamete fuses with this female gamete, you have one chromosome with YW plus and another chromosome with Y and W. I hope this is clear. Then next after this, when this male gamete fuses with this female gamete, you have one X chromosome with Y and W plus, another with Y chromosome. So here you can see these all are female progenies, okay, of F2 generation. These are male progenies. Now you can see here Y plus W plus, which is present in parents, okay, YW, which is also present in parents, then Y plus W plus, parental type. Again, this Y and W are in both the cases, again it is parental type, and Y and W is present, again it is parental type. Yes or no? So this four are what? Parental type. Okay, and this four, Y plus W, it is not there in parents. This combination is not seen in parents. So this is what? Non-parental, or you can say recombinant type. Here you have Y plus W. Okay, so this is also a new combination. Yes or no? Then next, Y and W plus, this is also not seen in parents. YW plus, again, this is also not seen in parents. So this four are what? Recombinant type. Yes, did you understand this? Now, what is the percentage of parental types? Means, what are the chances of the appearance of parental types? Okay, so here the percentage of appearance of parental type in the progenies of F2 generation is 98.7%. Okay, and what are the chances of recombinant types? Recombinant type is, the percentage of recombinant type is very less, that is 1.3% only. Okay, now why does parental type percentage is so much and recombinant type is less? The percentage of parental type is more because the genes lie close to each other. Okay, so they are inherited together in next generation. Okay, so therefore the parental type percentage is high. Okay, and the recombinant type percentage is low. I hope you have understood this. You just have to show gametes. Okay, and you will understand how to carry out the grant, how these are obtained. Okay, I hope everything is clear. Morgan's crosses are clear now. Okay, and how this percentage are obtained. Okay, I hope you have understood this video. If you like the video, do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you and keep watching. Thanks.